Welcome back to the Roadshow this morning in the Buzz. The holidays can be a difficult time for many people, leaving them feeling very lonely. And if you're one of them, you might be contagious.
No.
Well, a new study suggests that feelings of loneliness can rub off on friends, neighbors, spouses, and even acquaintances. And lonely people also tend to isolate themselves in small groups, which just feeds those feelings of solitude. Now, it's actually based on a group of more than 5,000 people in Framingham, Massachusetts. The average age is 64, and over a period of years, they completed questionnaires asking how many days during the previous week they experienced a particular feeling. So what do you guys think? Contagious loneliness?
Well, I think the big key here is that you're talking about people in their 60s.
Mm.
Much different mindset than people in their 20s and 30s and 40s.
Yeah. Mm.
And social activity as well. So
yeah.
I kind of throw that out of the equation. If you're talking about 30-year-olds, 40-year-olds, then I say, well, we've got a little more credence to this study.
Mm. Yeah.
But when you're talking about 60-year-olds, not to say that they're all, you know, all 60-year-olds are like that, but there is a higher percentage
mm-hmm. yeah.
of people who start to get into their 60s and 70s who suffer depressive feelings at
yeah.
this time of year.
Yeah,
what
I don't think it's just loneliness, because you're saying that lonely people stay away from people.
Right.
I think it might be depression that makes it, because when you're depressed, you stay in the house, you stay in bed, you don't want to be around people, mm-hmm. you don't feel as though you're good enough to be in the outside world, which mm-hmm. I think that's more of the problem here is the depression rather than the loneliness. And yeah, if you're around a depressed right. person, if they can't make you happy, they're going to make you sad. So,
mm-hmm.
Well, I think one feeds into the other.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, quite frankly, you know, you have good friends, if you have people who are depressed, that will try to help you.
Right.
But there are also a lot of friends that will stay away from you
right.
because they don't want to be around you, frankly.
Or they don't know what to do. They don't know,
they don't know how to help.
They don't know what to say.
Exactly.
They don't want to say something
exactly.
That could be awkward.
Exactly.
I don't know. I think I can understand a little bit about this. I think that if you have a spouse who is lonely or depressed,
mm-hmm.
that can be very influential. Just like you were saying, there's a tug of war. And, you know, I know in life that mm-hmm. there are givers and takers.
Sure.
And so sometimes you find yourself at the other end of the spectrum to whatever your,
right.
you know,
a
good friend.
Yeah, I would have liked to have seen him done a study from 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s.
Yeah,
I agree.
And then, you know, meld them over and say, you know, we looked at this and we were surprised to find that people in their late 30s and 40s
right.
were actually depressed more this time of the season in comparison to people in their 60s and maybe 70s.
And it is a very difficult time of year because people have such high expectations,
well, sure.
especially for the holidays.
Yeah,
so.
There are definitely a lot of people, and there might be infighting inside the family or whatever, and they just look at this type of year and just be like, you know what, I just don't even want to bother.
You well, know. You know, I'm curious to hear what Courtney Caligiuri has to say, because you were piping up, Court, just a moment ago. Do you think that's true? Do you think that lonely people, maybe it's contagious?
Yeah, I think all the emotions are contagious. Don't you think if we have happy folks around work, kind of brings your spirits up, or maybe if you get in an argument at home or someone at your house has a bad day at work, it kind of gets to you and you're kind of cranky too. I mean, that's how we all feel on the live blog, that it's definitely contagious, including with the weather. You know, everything rubs off on you. This one's from Lisa. She said, think about it. If someone in your house is in a bad mood, doesn't it rub off on you? And Evan says, yes, emotions rub off. If someone's in a good mood around me, I'm usually happy. But if people are upset, crying, etc., then it brings me down a little, he said. Here's our poll on foxprovidence.com. Do you think emotions are contagious? Yes, others' emotions rub off on us, or no, emotions are based on an individual. So you can weigh in there, and we've got about 6 comments on our Facebook page, and Daniel Slavin says, of course emotions are contagious. All you need is one person at work to be miserable. It's like a giant storm cloud. And Alex said, absolutely, one person's emotions can affect another person's emotions, and so on. So I'm not sure what the moral of the story is. I guess we got to pay attention to ourselves then, right? But I'll be back in about 30 minutes with your poll results. For now, back to the kitchen. Lily, what's